Competitioning means that the way of mind, especially the idea, norm, value, and especially the behavior of particular group of people or society. Ladies and gentlemen, we are the government side strongly agree with this motion. So that's all my speech.
Next, may I invite the captain of common science, Ms. Yuna?
First of all, may I pay my great respects to venerable lecturer Rizai as the judges and the house with a very good afternoon. I am Linda, the captain representing the opponent side, and we are here today to oppose to the motion proposed which says that tourism is destroying our culture. On contrary to the proposition side, we absolutely believe that tourism is not destroying our culture. In fact, it is the most important element to bring our nation to bloom. To begin with our argument, I would like to give some definition of some keywords in the motion. First is, what is tourism? Tourism is the business providing services such as transportation, places to stay, or entertainment for people who are on holiday. And what about culture? Culture is the way of life, which is generally about the like belief or custom of one particular group of people at a particular time. So to say that tourism is destroying our culture, it implies that the ordinary business can somehow disproportionately affect to one entity of one country. Does it make any sense to all of you? I don't think so. In fact, tourism is not destroying our culture, but it brings about benefits to our country, such as environmental issues. For example, imagine that you go to visit one place and this is not with a good environment. So, do you want to visit that place again? So, here is the point. Tourism can help us to think about our environmental, improve our environmental issue, and better our environment. Thank you.
Oh, wow. I see, it's very interesting. Oh, very interesting motion. And now, may I invite the first speaker of the government side, Mr. Nasi.
Good afternoon, honorable board, judge, venerable boss, and all lady and gentlemen who are present here again. I'm the first speaker of the government side, which is standing on the strong agreement of the motion, say that tourism is destroying our culture. Based on me, I put the argument is tourism is destroying the material culture. Sociology colleagues, when we study about sociology, the types of culture, there are two types. The first is non-material, and the second is material. So here, I write about material culture, which is impacted by tourism. The first is about cultural tourism. As I want to write, is Angkor Wat Temple. It's the best cultural tourism place in our country. And why is tourism is destroying the cultural place? You know, as the news recently appeared, one of the group of foreign went to the Angkor Wat Temple. You know what did they do? Some of them take a photograph without clothes of the girl. And so what happened? It affects so much to the values of our temple, which is the best symbol of our country. And by the way, there might some tourists without without a much thinking of the values of one place, they see the letter of some place that they are put, do not touch or something. Or sometimes, please apologize if I say something that inappropriate word, like if some tourists, they touch a breast of the Apsara. So you see that this kind of unvaluable action which tourists treat our well-built sculpture. One more thing, talk about tourism business. Let me raise the company of Uncle Beer. You see that? The logo of Uncle Beer was that. It's the temple, it's the heart of Cambodian people, it's the best symbol of our country. But why do they put this symbol to the beer, to the bottle of beer? But actually, if we use this beer in our country, if we drink this beer in our country, it doesn't cost much. But what actually the company have exported and imported. So they will export this kind of product to abroad. And then when the foreigners see the symbol of our country, the symbol of our Cambodian heart on the bottle of the beer, they will check us, it's the drinker people. As in answer, Cambodian people is well-educated or polite or something like that. But actually, because of the business tourism trip, our country with the cultural place like that, so they look down on our culture. Thank you. That's all for my speech.
Next, may I invite the first speaker of the performance side, Miss Tan.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Tanya, I'm from the opening side. As the blue side has said, Don Gobe is destroy our culture. And I just as your government side, you didn't protect your product, own product, and you look at them is a bad way. And it's the beer that output of the country, they will know that it's a symbol of Cambodia and it's our culture. It's our culture instruction. And traveling and it's not destroyed the traditional my culture and it's help or develop our my culture. Traveling is bring people to in each other who traveling bring people into contact with each other and also develop between people and culture and provide the cultural exchange with host and guest. Because of this, it is the opportunity to increase our culture. And said, it's all in here.
Oh, for the first speaker of the government side and the opponent side, they have a very confident. Oh, now see what is going on. Please welcome to the guest speaker, Mr. Muni.
Greetings, judges and the audience. I am Muni, the second speaker for the government side. First off, I would like to apologize for any use of words that may be inappropriate or offensive in any way. Please forgive me. Now, getting back to the point, in addition to the first speaker, he said that tourism is destroying our material culture. Now I'm going to raise awareness of how tourism is affecting our non-material culture. You see, through a business tourism, we can say about mass media from Eastern states like USA or Europe or British and some other country like Korea or Japan, you can see that their media have been broadcasted to our country, and then especially music or music video, we see that during in those music videos, the dancer, especially the female dancer in those music videos, often wear tight, skimpy or revealing outfit. And when the Cambodian people view those music videos, they began to think, they will think that it may be okay to wear those outfits in public. Or some people might even appreciate them because they wear something that might make them look attractive without thinking much about our values about appropriate clothing.
And of course, it's not just the women that began thinking about them. The men, most Cambodian men think it is okay. It's not even a good thing that women wear short, like wear short and revealing outfits. So what happened? Where is the value of bokeh clothing? It all went down the drain. Before we think that we give much value to bokeh clothing, and when we would patronize those who do not wear bokeh in the public, but now no one really cares. They think that it is okay to wear tight and revealing outfit because maybe they think, just maybe, it might be part of culture, but in fact it is not part of culture. And through those mass media, we can see that it is destroying a part of our culture. That is the beliefs, norms, beliefs, and ideas. That is all my achievements. Thank you for listening.
Competition.
Now, next, may I invite the guest speaker of the opponent side, Miss Butai.
Good afternoon, class. I would like to pay my respect to one of them all, literally assess as the judge and all my classmates. First, I would like to disagree with the second speaker of the government side. Every widow or music widows, like other, you said that other widow from other countries wear short or something like that. Wear short or something like that, it represents their cultures, it's not our cultures. So as I'm standing here, I would like to disagree that tourists is destroying our culture, but in fact, it's helping to develop our economy. First, we all know that tourists is helping our is giving our employment opportunities, and tourists create jobs in many different areas. When tourists come, hotel, restaurants. Car rental agencies, tours companies, and more other can provide opportunities for local people to be employed. And for example, as you already know, Angkor Wat is a famous tourist place famous in Cambodia. Like, in every year, around 2.3 million people visit our Angkor Wat. So many hotels need many staff, and also like many other restaurants are being opened. And open. So it's the opportunity to give people and a job. And secondly, is social advantage. It's a pride of local communities and and all the tourists can take a look at their cultures, at their history, cultural heritage, and cultural heritage. To sum up, it's like tourists are very important to our countries or other countries. It play an important role in also exchanging cultures between countries, and also to make our economy grow from stronger. That's all.
As you see, inside they have many ideas and with their confidence to support their motion that make our even more competitive. So now please welcome the captain of the government side. Vulnerable, Sophie, you have 2 minutes to conclude.
Yes, actually I don't care about what I've been talking about, environment or economy. But I just know that tourism is destroying my culture, our culture. You know, Angkor Wat Temple is the place that our community people used to respect, used to worship. But The people use their place for earn money to get money. You are happy with that? This is our country. And I'm glad to speak here today, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want you to believe me, but I want you to make by your own decision. This true or not, it's right or wrong. And so I'm speaking today, I want you to know our culture is very important. Today we can show to the world that this land is belong to us, this country is belong to us because of our culture. And so that's all my point.
Now, for the captain of opponent side, you have 2 minutes to conclude your point.
Yeah. So, tourism is not destroying our culture, as what the government side has said, only to some reason. What do you mean about influent material culture, fashion, dress, mass media? Do you know what? Do you know the definition of this word? Actually, tourism is not about influence our culture, but it's about putting out ourselves, promoting our culture, and spread our lifestyle as well. So, about the influence, about the material culture, fashion, mass media, it there's nothing to do with tourism, but it's about the government regulation to do with it. And we still strongly believe that tourism is not destroying our culture due to some reason as mentioned. It's about environmental issue improvement. It's about cultural exchange and about economic development. Here is one quote. Tourism is still the most intense mode of learning. The product doesn't destroy our culture and the fashion means nothing. Thank you.
Oh, it's very interesting. Interesting. And the audience, and all my beloved audience, do you enjoy this event?
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, please have 10 minutes break while our judges. I will keep so hard with the reason. Thank you.